think my favorite part about being a web developer is that there's no shortage of new things to learn and new problems to solve. Last year in 2021, I rebuilt my side project MTB Group Rides using Ionic and React on the front end, Elixir with an extension called Ash on the back end, and then I tied it all together with GraphQL. In the last half of the year, I started learning Flutter for cross-platform mobile development. Within that time, I was able to publish a solitaire game using plain Dart and Flutter to the Android App Store. It was pretty cool. I don't know if it's my undiagnosed ADHD, but I love finding and building new things with tech. And this is why I'm going to learn Rust in 2022. I'm going to become a Rustation. Cue the Crab Will Rave music. Here are my five reasons for learning Rust. It's a super popular language loved by a lot of developers. The majority of developers I talk to that have used Rust have said they loved it, and they love that it was super easy to develop and super fast. Developers worldwide have voted Rust their most loved language 6 years in a row on the Stack Overflow survey, which is pretty incredible. My second reason why I'm learning Rust is it helps you write dependable code. If you've heard anything about Rust, you know there's an unsafe way of writing code, and the compiler will let you know when you're writing code that's unsafe. But what does that mean? Well, it can mean anything from a runtime error that could happen, or it could be a potential memory leak that you're gonna have in your production code. So it helps you find out about those errors before they actually happen, which is great. If you're coming from just TypeScript, like me, I've never used a compiled language, and you can think of it as TypeScript on steroids. My third reason that piggybacks off of the last reason, not only is it safe, it's fast as fuck. A coworker recently described it as jumping into a NASCAR race and you're just driving along, but you have famous NASCAR driver Richard Petty in your passenger seat, and he's just yelling at you and coaching you the entire way. You're going 200 miles an hour. Richard Petty's over there yelling, "Turn left, pass this person, don't hit the wall." So you can think of Richard Petty in this analogy as the compiler in Rust, and it's just telling you how to stay safe while you're writing code that's gonna be blazing fast. The fourth reason why I'm learning Rust is because of WebAssembly. As a web developer, I'm always gonna bet on web technologies. For the longest time, it's been HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. In the recent years, our apps have become more and more JavaScript dependent to the point where huge payloads were coming over in these single page apps, causing slow page loads. We've created things like code splitting, which is great. The Jamstack came along and is eliminating a lot of the JavaScript that goes to the browser. WebAssembly steps in as a binary VM that can run in the browser. And it's already implemented by all the four major browsers right now. It's been on my radar for a long time as a potential game changer for the JavaScript side of browser code. My fifth, and honestly, the main reason I'm gonna learn Rust in 2022 is I'm gonna dive into Web 3.0 tech, learning Solana, which is built using Rust. For the longest time, I've been trying to stay away from the hype of Web 3.0 and cryptocurrency. But recently I made the mistake of watching a Next.js conference talk by Nader Davit. I'll link it down below if you wanna watch it as well. But it made me start thinking about what a dApp could be. And Web 3.0 isn't a complete game changer. It's not gonna completely wipe out all the Web 2.0 apps. It's just an extension of the current web as we know it. I'm still gonna continue to learn Flutter as I learn Solana. But if you wanna join me in this journey of learning Rust, go ahead and subscribe. I'll be going live as I learn Rust and Web 3.0, Solana. So if you wanna keep up, look out for the live notifications, and I hope to see you there. Peace out.